What is that disturbing meteora?
What do you mean they have deals with the meteoras?
Did they trick us?
They trapped us in here so they could have the surface all to themselves?
Is that why all I get to eat is this print food?
Print food?
It seems the video of the humanoid meteora was a big factor.
This isn't good. It's already grown this much? There are already too many to persuade one by... Huh? Hey, Alba, isn't that a Patroclus mask?
Wake up, people of the city! This city is a prison disguised by textures! We are being exploited by Prometheus! Cut off from the bountiful surface, surrounded by hollow fakes, and forced to live in poverty! As though we were livestock! That towering elevator pillar that leads to the top is what separates us from the surface! We will take control of it and head to our new frontier! Overflowing water, trees,
no.
And flowers!
There's nothing on the
we
surface!
All with our own hands! Let us march!
Yeah!
It's stupid!
Who is that? I'm arresting whoever it is, even if I have to knock him out!
Wait, Yamato! That's just an avatar. It's not real. I can't read any of his info, even with Prometheus's clearance. Just who is that?
Vacate the area immediately.
This is bad. Argos drones are here!
Yeah.
I repeat, vacate the area immediately.
Hey, you guys quiet down! Stop listening to that guy! I told you to calm down! We're not enemies!
Okay, this is not good.
This voice.
Okay, well, Noah's singing.
So pretty. Noah?
Are you looking for Starlight? Are you shouting because you're sad? Are you suffering because you want love? Yes. That's why everyone is crying, because you're sad.
It's true that she's manipulative, damn.
But there's no need to be worried anymore. I am always by your side.
Noah, so pretty. I wanted to see you.
Noah is love. I stand close to people, and I will never leave. If you're crying, I will comfort you. If you're happy, I will laugh with you. I will try to care for each and every one of you equally. I am able to do that because I am a fantasy created by love that is more real than anything. As long as you call out for me, I'll be there. So please, show me your happy faces. If you can't smile, I will soothe you. If you can't see the light of the stars, I will open your eyes to their glow. If you cry, you won't be able to hear my song. I will sing for you here to get close to you. Now send your tears to the stars and throw them at me.
This is crazy.
I will shower you with love in return.
Noah is amazing. Everyone is smiling already.
Because she's manipulating the emotions of other people. What are you talking about?
The Argos drones left too, and that masked guy ran away.
Wow! Noah is so cool, isn't she? She's a star, a real one. Let's help pump things up. Noah, you're the best!
Oh no, another concert? Shit. Okay.
In every darkest night, say come on, close your eyes, it'll be alright. I'll be here when you need me the most.
They fucking put money in this game this time compared to Tokyo Chronos.
Praying here down on my knees.
Let's go with the story.
Noah might not be fake.
What?
I've always been suspicious of Noah, too. Appearing after Coco's death. Being something similar to Coco. Noah's just like Anima that way. And she can't enter the sunroom. I thought she was some suspicious fake that Coco rejected. But Noah genuinely does care about people.
Sounds like it.
There is no doubt that her feelings are real. Shouldering unnecessary responsibility yourself. Huh. And for the masses. Compared to me, who couldn't even save one friend.
Chloe, why don't you throw her a star?
A star?
Huh?
Yeah. I'm sure Noah would be really happy. I told you. There's no reason to compare Noah to Coco. If you find someone you think is more wonderful than you, then you should tell them how wonderful they are.
Oh. Oh.
Thank you, Alba.
Yeah. Thanks for the wonderful song.
Hmm.
Is this like a like in their world or something?
Chloe!
Just this one time.
Hmm.
What now? Come on.
Honestly, you're such a slow learner. You can't touch anything because it's a hologram. Have you not figured that out yet? All you do is act on instinct. Stupid. Well, there. Not that you could touch me, but... You bear your claws at me, and you get punished. Ooh, it's gonna hurt.
Professor, please stop provoking it for your own amusement. I feel sorry for Anima.
You feel sorry for it. Does this meteora look like it needs your pity?
It does. You're using the inhibitor too much and for no real reason. Anima's barely had any energy lately as is.
It does look weakened compared to when we first brought it here.
It fought off a meteora right after it healed from its battle with the Altomachia. It could just mean it hasn't recovered its stamina yet. It hasn't eaten yet, either.
Yeah, they didn't eat any human.
What? This is a meteora. They don't eat what humans do.
Indeed. As long as we don't know what meteors eat, we can't give it food. However, this isn't just a regular meteora. It's a meteora that's eaten a person.
Yamato, you're a substitute.
If taking in a human has changed its appearance, bone structure, and organs, there's a big possibility its biology is close to human, too. So, Chloe, I order you to study it. See if it's just a regular meteora or a new type that has humanity. It's your job to find that out.
Me?
Why, Chloe? Isn't it more efficient to have you study it, Julie?
Fool. If I do all the work I can delegate, what was the point in making all of you? You two will be my hands and feet, and I'll be the brains. That's the smart way.
But...
Besides, what if Coco's personality is laying dormant inside it? Or if Coco herself has been sleeping within it this whole time? Think, who better to awaken Coco than the one who knew her best? Chloe. Am I wrong? I'm not, am I, huh?
This forum is a trick. A disguise to make Chloe drop her guard. I won't let you do exactly what it wants and allow Chloe to get close to...
Okay, okay. Shut up already. How about this then? I'll give Chloe the inhibitor. You've seen how effective this is, Chloe.
Professor, I think that's enough.
Now, good luck studying it.
Damn it.
Chloe, I've prepared a few useful items.
Okay.
Okay.
What about revival thing in case I die?
Can't say I'm excited. But orders are orders. I'll let you know when I'm ready. Let's begin.
Yeah.
I'll record its responses. Chloe, try handing Anima various items.
Mm-hmm, okay. That's gonna be interesting.
Chloe, what do you want to try?
I would choose both recording and mirror. I think recording of Amicutira's cry would be interesting because they are singing, but I don't know.
Interesting. It's wary of mm-hmm. another meteora's voice?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, my ears!
Ah, shit!
Whoa. It's okay. The sound waves in Anima's room aren't all reaching here. So none of us would be alright after a direct hit from that.
I think it's trying to break the wall!
Don't worry. The room Anima is in is made from the same material as Machia armor. It's very sturdy.
But is this okay? You can't guarantee our safety if we continue on like this.
Hmm.
Could this mean that it recognizes other meteoras as enemies?
Hmm.
Let's try something else.
Let's do a Audio of Noah concert? That's interesting.
In every darkest night, say,
oh,
it's reacting to the sound. It's able to sense melodies and harmonies like humans and animals.
Well, of course, because of the singing. Oh!
Is it singing along to Noah's song?
It looks that way. What a pretty voice. Seems like it has vocal cords. Good job, Chloe.
Thank you.
Let's call that a day. I'll put the study results together.
Thank you.
Hey, Chloe, what did you think about today's study? What did you think Anima was? Just a meteora? Or did it seem like it had some sort of humanity?
I don't know if I should keep quiet, but postpone judgment, I think,
I don't know.
Because of the studies.
I can't think about anything right now.
Oh, does that mean you sense something human in it?
No, I just...
Well, this certainly has gotten interesting.
Well, yeah, of course.
What in the world is it?
What?
Would a meteora do something like that? It's as if it were a child. I just don't know.
These are yesterday's study results.
The unique seems closer to human than to meteora.
Hmm.
Let's hand in Coco's belongings today.
Oh, yeah. Good idea.
Huh? Why would we...
Isn't it obvious?
You're right.
The Unique became more human because it consumed Coco. How much memory, thought, or ability can a meteora extract from a human they consumed? That's what we're testing.
So, does that mean we're gonna take things Coco used or liked and mm-hmm. give it to that meteora? Can we really tell if it has Coco's memories from that?
Well, we'll see. It doesn't hurt to try.
Well, we'll at least know whether we can tell or not after these experiments. Einstein once said that God does not play dice with the universe.
Okay.
And I agree. This creature that has both human and meteoric characteristics, this creature that could change our future. It would be boring if it just happened by random chance. Why does it look like Coco? Why did it appear before us now? There has to be a reason or rule to it. There has to be some hidden intention. Let me say this loud and clear. There is meaning for everything. If we can bring out its Coco side, we might be able to find out the meaning behind it. You want to know, don't you? You should if that tiny brain of yours works. Your curiosity must be screaming at you to take action, right?
Yeah, I suppose.
He doesn't care.
This is stupid. Don't do this, Chloe. You're really going to give the Meteora Coco's things?
Of course.
That's only going to confuse you more. You don't need to listen to stupid orders.
But we can't deny that it would be a key to understanding Anima's existence.
Are you saying that it's worth making Chloe suffer then?
Of course. I wouldn't force her. It's your choice, Chloe. What do you want to do?
Of course we're giving.
If giving it Coco's belongings will help solve some of the Unique's mysteries, then I think it's probably worth trying.
Oh, you're being pretty cooperative today, Chloe.
Yes, I think this is much more constructive than mulling things over and doing nothing.
Mm-hmm.
We need to move forward. I'm sure solving Anima's mystery will also benefit Coco.
I actually predicted you'd agree, and already got Coco's things ready.
Thank you.
You went into Coco's room without permission?
Oh, come on.
Don't worry about that. Just give it some of the things I brought. Test out whatever you want.
Just think what she thought is gonna react.
Good luck.
Are you kidding me? What if this is exactly what the Meteora wanted?
What? Eat a flower or something?
I said this before. It's a Trojan horse. We need to kill it before it destroys the city.
That's what we're studying it for, Noah. You shouldn't just blindly label it friend or foe.
Well, I've already warned all of you. If this blows up in our faces,
we're dead.
It's on you. Do whatever you want then.
Yes. Thank you. Bye. Yeah.
Chloe, I understand where Noah is coming from. She must be worried about Chloe in the city.
She's never met Coco before. That's why she's not bound by the past like we are.
You're right. We need to prove that Anima isn't dangerous.
Okay, no. She is dangerous. It's just the origin of her.
I'll talk to you when I'm ready.
Well, I'm ready now.
Let's begin.
Chloe, what do you want to try?
What do we have? Constellation shard or song? What the fuck is phony? Constellation, of course.
Well, well. It seems quite interested. It even looks like it's reading it.
Do Meteoras even know what constellations are? Even I have no idea what I'm looking at.
I mean, they're coming from space, right? So, I think.
We don't know where Meteoras come from. But if they come from outer space, it could be that she's remembering her homeworld.
That's a pretty wistful way of thinking. Though a simple picture printed on paper can't capture the vast wonders of space.
Then the way it's reading that book, does that come from Coco's memories?
Could be.
We can't make any conclusions from just that. However, it's a possibility. It seems to recognize that as a book, even though it's never seen one before.
Huh.
Chloe, let's try the next one.
Mm-hmm. Sun Coco Light. I mean, that's obvious. Why there is even option for inhibitor? I don't care.
Is this a song Coco liked?
I don't know, I think.
Yes. It's one of the songs she listened to.
Uh-huh.
It's as if she's listening to her favorite song. Do you think it likes what Coco likes, Chloe?
Obviously.
It's just a coincidence.
Okay, Chloe. Thanks to your diligent work studying the Meteora, I think we have a much better picture, don't you? About whether or not Anima seems influenced by Coco?
Mm-hmm.
Let's enter the next phase then. Chloe, I want you to go choose something that belonged to Coco yourself and bring it here.
Yeah, that's gonna be interesting.
Her favorite food, favorite toy, or whatever. I'll leave the choice to you.
Okay.
Why would I give it something that belonged to Coco?
I told you, it's to determine whether it's a Meteora or Coco.
Yeah.
Don't tell me you're not curious yourself. We could be close to finding out what's inside Anima. Or do you want to quit after coming this far?
No. We're going in.
I'll go to the sunroom when I'm ready.
So you're ready now.
About time to go.
I think what I'm gonna give her.
Something that's connected to Coco. What should I bring? What would the unique respond to? The Coco inside it.
Wait, Chloe!
What?
You shouldn't walk alone in the city. Patroclus has been active lately, so it's real dangerous.
I guess.
Don't worry. Resistance or not, they're not going to attack recklessly at random.
That's true, but just to be safe. Besides, we can help you carry Coco's belongings.
It's gonna be a small thing, don't worry.
I don't plan on bringing so many items that I need help carrying them.
Yeah.
Well, you never know. For example, you wouldn't be able to carry a desk on your own.
Why would I need a desk, moron?
I don't plan on bringing something big like...
Ugh, whatever.
Now then, something connected to Coco, huh? When I first heard about it, I wasn't sure what to bring. But now that I'm here, it's full of things that remind me of Coco. There are so many choices. What do you think would be good?
There isn't exactly a standard to base our decision on, but we can't bring everything.
Shit, okay, that's gonna be mandatory then.
Carefully. Chloe, is there anything notable for you?
Yeah. First of all, I would pick Dahlia, like, for sure, but I don't think there is any. Phony, no. Ribbon, for sure, I'm gonna pick. I'm not gonna pick wheelchair. I'm gonna pick music box as well, so I think I'm gonna pick two things, right? I'm not sure about this.
This digital but... music box.
Yeah.
Hey, Chloe.
What? It just suddenly...
Did that startle you? I've always wanted to startle you like this.
Did you make this music box play? But how?
Well, it's not an ordinary music box.
What do you mean?
My father gave it to me, along with this phony. I can control it with my voice from a distance.
Huh.
The escort mode keeps records of it every day and makes adjustments by taking my brainwaves and voice into consideration.
Whoa!
Why have something so important here? I assumed it was just an old music box.
I keep it here precisely because it's important. I really like this music box. Did you know, Chloe? The beautiful tone from the music box comes from the wooden box resonating.
Yes.
This device was digitalized, but it automatically tunes to my voice. It plays bright tones when I'm happy and sings for me when I'm sad to cheer me up.
Wow, okay.
It seems like my emotions are tuned to it. It feels like another part of me. Hey, Chloe. Make sure to always keep this music box here, because it's very important to me. I always want it here, by your side in the sunroom, far into the future.
No, we can't take this music box. I promised Coco.
But we should. No, we're taking this. Obtain!
Coco.
Okay, we have two things.
Did you find something good, Chloe?
Yeah. I'm not sure about phony. I don't think phony is gonna be important. I think this music box is gonna be key. And ribbon to resemble Coco. I think that's the most appropriate choices. Let's go.
I see. Hopefully, objects Coco interacted with every day would be able to stimulate elements of Coco within Anima.
I hope so.
Of course, that's only if there's truly any Coco in Anima.
What happens if there isn't any? Or if it breaks any of these?
Yeah, if it breaks this music book, that's gonna be tragic.
Let's hope that doesn't happen.